Okay, it's time for a new painting, watercolor, simple watercolor. I'm going to use mainly three colors, cobalt blue, burnt sienna, raw sienna, and a little bit alizarine crimson and yellow for the roof. Or I take some burnt sienna. It must stand out a bit. So, I'm gonna paint on Millford paper. It's English paper. I like it a lot. It's a bit Watman paper from the past. It's a bit water resistant, but I like that. So I've palette here with some colors, a bit dirty, but okay. We need a gray and a blue, not a punch blue, but I mix cobalt blue, but this is way too blue. So I do a little bit of alizarine crimson, so it is less blue. Mix enough water with it, because the sky is always light. Then we need the gray. Same blue. A lot more alizarine. I think it's okay. Well, we need a bit of light here, so I begin to paint in the middle. It's way too dark, so I take clean water and pick it up. Clean brush, cobalt blue on the sides. Put a clash here, clash there. We like simple skies. Clean brush. Soft edges. Just play with it. Oops. You saw that it happened? My brush was slightly wetter than the paper, So I get almost so cauliflower thing. We don't like that. I have always sponge. So I can wipe the excess paint off. I take a little bit of raw sienna, very diluted. A little bit of burnt sienna through it, just to make it a little dirty on the horizon. You paint around the house. And on the horizon, there are several things happening here. There are houses, there are little houses, there are boats. There. So we need a smaller brush to suggest things that are there. And we suggest them by not painting them, but we go around them. Nothing fancy, just don't paint it all. Here's a shadow, so we have a nice pattern of shapes here. We need bit of softness here. I should take a bigger brush. Good. To the water again. Same mix, cobalt blue. We are brave. Don't paint just the waterline, paint a bit in the land. So here we get a green of cobalt blue, a raw sienna, for a nice soft green, blue green. Variate your greens, because green is the most boring color. Well, it's not a boring color, but it can easily be boring when you paint it all in one tone. I need even more. Bit of gray. This is painting from the heart. I hope it is okay. Okay, noise. You know, you see how light it dries on Millford. It's really make a powdery look. I love it. I hope you do too. So we paint around the trees. Here and there. We need a small brush. Rigger. And something bigger. Okay. Cobalt, Burnt Sienna, and we just think trees, green, we cut the house. Make sure it is wet, moist. A little bit of water. Choop. Cobalt blue, Burnt Sienna, little stiffer mix. We make the branches. A little more wet in the wet. Look for here that you make something that is there. I don't care what, but suggest things. I used to suggest a tree, I don't know, but when something green is behind the house, it's usually the tree, so don't make a hush, or how you say that. Water again. Make sure it is clean water. This is the side of the paper. This is totally not important what is here. It needs a shape, nothing more. For my liking, I painted here too much green, but okay, I just can make a few branches. Okay, now we need softer trees here, because it's further away. So we wet the first, and we make it a little slightly bluer. We cut around the houses here again. See, because I wet it first, I get a soft shape. And soft, say, further away. Simple as that. Okay, we need the darker line here, so we take, I take a little bit of ultramarine blue and burnt sienna. A little bit of cobalt too. Cut in the house. A little bit more water, lighter gray. Maybe the house is a bit too dark, but okay. That's okay. Cobalt blue, burnt sienna. Nothing here, you don't need nothing there, but just fantasize that there is something. Painting out intuition, I just learned on Facebook. Okay, that's nice. I liked it. I think I need, knowing the Millford paper, I think I need a little bit more dark around. This is the focal point. So this is not where you want me, I want you to look, but this is it. So here comes darks. the darker is dark and the light is light, you know. The what they say. Okay. The foreground needs a little work, not much, just the same mix. Cobalt blue, a little bit of raw sienna. Here I don't want you to look, so this is just a shape. Normally I tilt the paper a bit, so the gravity helped me a bit, but now I do it with the brush. Also here water. You see all kind of nice granulation developing while I lift some water from the floor. Yeah, I don't know. We dry it again. Okay, a little bit of green palette. I need a crispy orangey color. So I take a little brush. Everybody does we have one here? A little bit of the house. Is it enough orange or need I a little more orange? we'll I think it's okay. Here are also a few, but they need softening. Maybe here. You never know. Something is bothering me here. It's under the house. So I take a bit of Cobalt Blue, Burnt Sienna, mix green again. And go in it. Little bit of light red for the roof, always nice. Okay, so all we need is little bit of reflections. Don't paint exactly what is there above, just the colors is enough. It rhymes also. Make it soft. Then it will be okay. Is it enough? Is it not enough? I don't know. A good thing is always a darker band. On the front of your painting, we have a low horizon, so the band is a little bit smaller than usual. A little bit of drying. Okay, it's dry. Let us look how it do with a mat. Well, rather nice. I've got also black matte. Well, it's not 100%, but it is also nice. Stands out more. But we go for white. I think this is a nice place. Thank you all.